llegó la hora de disfrutar de su programa Nuestra Hora con Leti. Les presento a Leti Ortiz, productora ejecutiva y conductora de este programa lleno de alegría, entretenimiento, entrevistas, reconocimientos y mundo infantil Arizona. Nuestra Hora con Leti.
Hola, ¿qué tal, amigos? Soy Leti Ortiz, productora ejecutiva y conductora de Nuestra Hora con Leti. Bienvenidos un domingo más, un domingo hermoso, un domingo familiar aquí en Nuestra Hora con Leti. Y principalmente vamos a darle las gracias a nuestros dos patrocinadores principales, que es la Cámara de Comercio Hispana de Tucson y del Sol Research Management. Y también, pues aquí tengo a mis conductores que lo han hecho muy bien y este va a ser su segundo programa que van a estar conduciendo aquí conmigo. Como la Funny Group, tiene también un video que nos vamos a ir. ¿Qué es lo que te pasó en esta entrevista que hiciste?
Ahora sí que ya somos officially parte de tu programa.
Efectivamente,
Mike. Ahora sí, ya podemos decir. Pues fíjate que yo estuve en el Tejano Valentine's Dance en Casino del Sol y tuve la opportunity de entrevistar a Sunny Ozuna. He's a living legend. Y también entrevisté our very own Mr. Luis Marines de Misterio. Y we had a lot of fun.
Esta mujer sí que tiene fan.
Yo ando en todos lados. Se divierte. En todos lados ando. So yo les voy a traer todo el chisme tejano, la farándula tejana. Yo ahí voy a estar. Todo lo que se trate tejano, yo voy a estar ahí.
Y pues, mi Ricardo, con tu segmento, ¿qué te parece? Está lindo tu segmento, ¿eh?
Sí, nuevamente, Leti, muchísimas gracias por invitarme a tu programa, por ser parte de este proyecto. Como ya lo comentabas anteriormente, mi nombre es Ricardo Morales y traigo el segmento Contacto Empresarial. Si usted quiere hacer crecer su negocio, si usted ofrece algún servicio, contáctenos porque en eso nos especializamos.
Y el segmento de Mundo Infantil Arizona, le damos la bienvenida a este pequeño Alfonso. ¿Lo vieron? ¿Lo vieron en el programa anterior?
Sí, él ya parece un pro.
Sí. Entonces, también si tienen niños que tienen ese talento, les gusta el micrófono, les gusta la cámara, por favor, inscríbalos en Facebook. Por cierto, denos un like o llamen a este número telefónico que aparece en pantalla para inscribir a su niño para Mundo Infantil Arizona. Y acuérdate, Ricardo, que este programa, y mi Fanny, este programa es muy especial para nosotros, porque nos vamos a ir a los videos, a lo que grabamos en el 2016, que de verdad fue algo muy bonito, que ahora nos vas a platicar de cuál te recuerdas y cuál video vamos a ir a ver.
Claro, este es un programa especial, excelentes eventos que se llevaron a cabo en el año pasado, como es el de la Noche de Éxitos, Noche de Gala, que organiza la Cámara de Comercio Hispana de Tucson, por lo que los invitamos a que estén pendientes y vean el videoclip.
Y también fuimos a cubrir un evento hermoso que es el corte de listón del Sol Research Management, que es donde yo trabajo. Abrieron esta oficina especialmente para mí. Yo les mando un saludo muy cordial a todos mis amigos, a mis jefes, a mi jefa María Gallegos y a Wendy y a todos ellos. Les mando un cordial saludo a todos ellos y nos vamos a ir a verlos en este corte de listón. Ahí estuvimos presentes con la Cámara de Comercio Hispana haciendo el corte de listón. Estuvo muy bonito.
Excelente.
Estuvo muy bonito. Entonces, corre video y continuamos con más de
Nuestra Hora con Leti.
Como siempre, Nuestra Hora con Leti, estamos cubriendo el evento más grande, el evento donde es el glamour, es el evento donde toda la gente se hace presente. Tenemos más de 670, 50, more than a 600. Leah, you're very happy to have this gala every year here in El Casino del Sol.
We are. Casino del Sol is a wonderful partner for us, and we do have more than 650 people here tonight to honor our Hispanic Businessman and Woman of the Year and other gala honorees.
Así es, siempre cada año se está haciendo más grande este evento donde se hacen los premios y especialmente la mujer empresaria del año y el hombre empresario del año, que vamos a estarlos presentando en un momento. Leah, tell me about
What are you expecting tonight? I mean, it's a beautiful, beautiful people has been here tonight.
Yeah, tonight is just so much fun. Not only do we honor Hispanic entrepreneurs, and we honor those that do great work throughout Arizona and Sonora, but we're also here to have a good time. So we've got tortillas as appetizers. We're going to have some really special surprises inside. We've got a great band in store. We've got some beautiful ladies walking by in their gowns. You can see behind us, but this is just a really special evening.
Thank you so much, Leah, and we love to be here a part of this great event.
Thank you.
Continuamos con más.
Amigos, les recomiendo Leilani Che Creations con sus estilistas amables y profesionales. Y aquí nos atienden como en familia.
Leilani Che Creations, les esperamos para darles su nuevo look. Somos expertas en alto peinados para bodas, quinceañeras, proms o cualquier evento especial que tenga usted. ¡Los esperamos!
Para mí es un honor tener a un gran caballero que se le va a dar el reconocimiento esta noche. For me, it's a great to have you in Nuestra Hora con Leti. And how you feel? Your name and what do you do? I know you are a lawyer and you very important people, men here, especially the men. How do you feel to be the man of the year?
Thank you very much. I'm honored and privileged to be the Tucson Hispanic Chamber's Businessman of the Year. I'm a huge fan of the Chamber and the difference that they make within our community. So I'm just honored and humbled to have received this award.
And your family and friends, they're here and they're going to enjoy this beautiful award that you're going to receive tonight.
Yes, I have a lot of family and friends that are here. My parents, my brother, a lot of my co-workers as well. So obviously they're very proud of it and without their support, none of the things that I've been able to accomplish would be possible. I went to law school here in Tucson, and I've been practicing here in Tucson for 21 years.
21 years. Oh, my God. That's a beautiful to be here, and especially in our Latino community and our beautiful community here in Tucson, Arizona.
Oh, absolutely. Like I said, I love being a native of Southern Arizona, born and raised here. And coming from Nogales and being Hispanic, it's so important to give back to the community. So, I'm just very blessed and fortunate to, one, to have received this award and to be able to work with such amazing people.
Well, congratulations. Felicidades.
Gracias.
Felicidades. Thank you so much. And we're going to see you here.
Muy bien, Reina, les da la bienvenida a Trends Tradition Boutique y Joyería. Esta prestigiada boutique se especializa en moda exclusiva de la India y Pakistán, diseñada con las mejores telas de seda y algodón. Órdenes por catálogo en cualquier estilo y alteraciones están disponibles. Vestidos hechos de tela ideal para el clima del desierto. Exclusiva selección de joyería como piedras preciosas, plata exclusiva de la India, Nepal y Turquía. Lámparas de cristal, candeleros que son pintados a mano. Una inmensa selección de accesorios.
Y ahora tenemos el gusto de presentarles la mujer del negocios del año por la Cámara de Comercio Hispana de Tucson. Congratulations. How you feel tonight?
Thank you. It's very exciting.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
And tell me about Casa de la Luz Hospice.
Yes, Casa de la Luz Hospice. We started in 1998.
Uh-huh.
So in November we will be 18 years old. We take care of individuals who are at the end of their life.
Mm-hmm.
Our staff go in and support them and help their family through the process. Usually they're at home with their families or wherever they live, and we go in to provide support and help for them.
Oh, that's a beautiful. And tell me a little bit about how you feel tonight to be the woman of the year.
Thank you. I am humbled and truly honored. It's very special for me. I'm very proud of my Hispanic heritage.
Yes.
My great-grandfather came to Tucson from Sonora back in the 1880s with my grandfather. And so they settled here, and our family's always been very, very busy and active in the community. So I'm proud.
I know. You have a cousin. She's a singer.
Oh, yeah, Linda.
Linda Rostin.
Of course, she's the most famous.
I know Linda Rustin. I mean, I love her music. And I, when I was going to your profile, I was like, oh my God, that's your cousin?
Yes, yes, it is. We have a very musical family.
That's beautiful.
I have brothers and other cousins who do lots of singing. So.
Beautiful. That's so beautiful. And you know what? I'm very, very proud of you and the Casa de la Luz Hospice, because you guys, I mean, it's a beautiful thing to do. And especially because they speak Spanish there, too.
Yes, we have a whole team. The hospice is based on an interdisciplinary team of doctors and nurses and social workers and chaplains and home health aides and volunteers. And we have a whole team that is dedicated bilingual and some of them bicultural. And they take care of our Hispanic clients.
Thank you so much, and congratulations again. Felicidades, felicidades. And that's a beautiful to have you, that woman out of the year.
It's exciting to be here. Looking forward to a fun night.
Oh, yes.
I hear
yes.
that it's gonna all dance. Good. Gonna, oh, I heard yeah. that it's a good party.
It's a great party. Thank you so much. Congratulations. Continuamos con más. Listo, está el doctor Carmona, él realmente dice que habla español, pero ahora lo vamos a practicar más mi inglés con él. Vamos a practicar, we're going to practice your Spanish
yes,
too.
Yes, I will, yes, yes, necesito que practicar más.
Ya, yeah, porque dice que hablaba español cuando su abuelita.
Sí, sí, sí. Yeah, I spoke abuelita Spanish.
Abuelita, a usted le dan el award de Legacy.
Legacy Award, yes, yes.
¿Cómo se siente? How you feel tonight with this award?
Well, I was surprised. I didn't think I was, you know, I was nothing I was ever expecting. Uh-huh. But, you know, I hope that it will inspire other Hispanic youth to stay in school, get an education, because, you know, I came from a poor family. I dropped out of high school. And it changed my life. And so I do as much as I can in the Hispanic community to encourage kids to stay in school, get an education, because that'll set you free, just like my abuelita told me.
Oh, that's a beautiful message. That's a beautiful message because the Latino community, they need these type of models like you to say, okay, we grown up like a poor families, but look at you now. I mean, you are a nice work in the community here in Tucson.
Well, I love it, you know, but my mom and my abuelita always told me, you know, when you make it successful, don't forget where you came from and make sure that you bring people with you. And so, you know, my over 30 years in the community, I've spent as much time as I can on community activities, working with the underserved, working with the people who need health care, Arizona-Mexico Border Commission, working in northern Mexico and southern Arizona to, you know, mend the fences so we can, you know, have one big community and share. And a lot of medical work into Mexico. So, you know, it's just part of who I am, but I am really my grandmother, abuelita's grandson, and my mom's son, and that's what they would expect of me. The Hispanic Chamber of Commerce has brought us here, okay, and they're bringing all of the leaders together. And I think the people need to understand that we've still got a long journey to go. You know, we still have people who aren't getting health care. We still have some of our people who are suffering. And so we have to do everything we can to achieve social justice and equality for all people.
Yeah, you're right. So thank you so much. You want to give another message to our audience and Latino community?
See, I would. And I would like to thank the Hispanic Chamber for the honor they bestowed on me. And I will continue to do everything I can to make our community better, especially in the Hispanic community.
Oh, before you're leaving, and guess who's this, sponsored my dress. Ooh. You, Jenny's Fashion. Jenny's Fashion is in the South Side. It's really? In a boutique.
It's yeah. beautiful.
Look at this. Thank you.
Thank you so much.
So you look very handsome when you're with your tuxedo.
Thank you very much. So, you look beautiful.
Thank you. Thank you so much. And congratulations again.
Thank you very much.
¿Estás listo para hacer crecer tu negocio? Nosotros podemos ayudarlo. Únete a la Cámara de Comercio Hispana de Tucson.
Representamos más de 1,800 empresas en Arizona y México y contamos con oficinas regionales en Sierra Vista, Douglas y ambos Nogales.
La Cámara Hispana organiza eventos sociales, talleres de educación empresarial.
La Cámara presenta talleres de compras diseñados para ayudar a su empresa a hacer negocio con el gobierno y corporaciones.
No te pierdas esta oportunidad para un mayor éxito.
Y aquí tenemos a otro personaje que también le van a dar un premio esta noche. How you feel tonight? Yes, say your name and what do you receive tonight?
My name is Jaime Pasipuente. I was the former Consul General of Mexico in Nogales, Arizona. I feel honored and pleased with this award. I want to thank the Tucson Hispanic Chamber of Commerce for this recognition, this award.
Y se siente muy orgulloso, se siente muy contento porque habla los dos idiomas también.
Sí, me siento muy contento de regresar a Arizona. Es un lugar donde tanto mi esposa como yo estuvimos muy contentos. Yo también quiero señalar que este reconocimiento no hubiera sido posible con el trabajo que hice en Nogales, sin el apoyo de la comunidad, sin el apoyo de nuestra comunidad en Nogales, a toda la comunidad de Nogales, Arizona. Les agradezco muchísimo todo su apoyo y desde luego a la Cámara por este gran reconocimiento.
Pues es algo que usted se merece y yo, orgullosa de nuestra hora con Leti, darle a felicitarlo. A nombre de la Cámara de Comercio Hispana y también de nuestra hora con Leti.
Muchas gracias. Agradeciendo y me da mucho gusto estar aquí en Tucson, en medio de esta comunidad tan especial, tan vibrante. I'm really pleased to be back to Arizona and thank you very much for this recognition.
Un reconocimiento que usted se merece, señor. Hasta luego. Hasta luego. Felicidades. Ahora nos encontramos con estas bellezas que vienen representando. Hola, chicas, ¿cómo están? Vienen representando, digan.
Miss Latinoamérica.
Miss Latinoamérica, mi Lourdes García, ¿verdad? Sí. Qué hermosa. ¿De dónde vienen, chicas?
De aquí, de Tucson, Arizona.
De Tucson. ¿Y tú vienes de...?
Phoenix, Arizona.
De Phoenix, Arizona. Entonces nos visitan y ellas están aquí modelando para nuestra gala, nuestra noche de éxitos gala. Bueno, qué hermosas están. Miren los sombreros, qué bellos, y los vestidos hermosísimos. Chicas, vamos a hacer esto porque siempre ustedes nos van a ayudar en hacer. Continuamos con más de Nuestra Hora con Leti. Y ahora es un honor también presentarles a este gran señor que es el alcalde de Douglas, Arizona. Felicidades, señor.
Muchas gracias.
Dígame su nombre completo y de dónde es a usted originario.
Yo soy Daniel Ortega Jr. y soy original de Douglas, Arizona.
De Douglas, Arizona. What award you received tonight?
I received the Arizona Public Servant of the Year.
How do you feel? You feel contento, feliz.
Muy contento, muy feliz. Very honored to get this award tonight. It's a great organization, the Tucson Chamber of Commerce, and I'm so excited to be here tonight. And it's such an honor to be, have won this award.
You have your family, you have friends, and everybody's going to be your porra por aquí tonight?
Yes, we're going to have a big porra and more celebrations later tonight. My family's together and all my friends are here as well.
That's great. That's a good thing for that you have your family and they're going to see you receiving this beautiful and great award.
Yes, I'm very honored to have this award and to be named. I was very surprised and very honored to get this award.
Do you want to say something to our community here in Tucson?
I want to say thank you for giving me this honor. It's a pleasure and I'm so proud to be from Southern Arizona and to represent the community in such an honorable way.
Well, congratulations again, señor. Felicidades.
Hi, this is Fanny Girl from Tejano Nation, and we're at the Valentine's Tejano Dance here at the Casino del Sol in Tucson, Arizona, and I'm with the living legend, Mr. Sonny Osuna from the Sunliners. How are you feeling tonight, sir?
Happy. Fíjate que ha tenido sweet. It's been a while since we've been in Tucson, so we've been looking forward to it, and so I'm glad here tonight. And of course, we had a full house, which is really nice.
How are you feeling tonight?
Very good. The crowd was coming not only for Tucson, of course, they come from all the surrounding towns, which gave us a full house, and we're happy about that.
We had people from Phoenix, we had people from Guadalupe, we had people from Casa Grande. I mean, listen, anything from oldies, blues, tejanas, rancheras, mariachi. How do you do it to maintain in the music industry?
Well, you know, I was actually there cuando primero I'm actually one of the pioneers of Tejano music. It was actually created back in the day by Little Joey La Familia and ourselves. And we kind of set the rules as to what the Tejano was going to be about. And it was going to be about a variety of different types of music in the same dance. It wasn't going to be cumbias all night or polkas all night or rock and roll all night. It was going to be a combination of different types of music. And that's what we still are doing today.
Awesome. So I know you've done it all. I mean, you've sang everything. What is up with Sunny Osuna? What's your next step?
Well, actually, I'm in five genres of music, and the latest two that we added was country, gospel, and of course, we're working on Christmas carols también. So I'm still a songwriter. I was a songwriter from almost day one, so I still do that. But I also write in Tejano and rock and roll, so it all comes together.
What advice can you give the younger generation that are starting in the music industry?
Well, first of all, I'll tell you what happens to us because, and I'm probably Little Joe and Roel Ramos and Freddy Martinez and everybody will tell you the same thing. We have very strict parents growing up. And it was always, education is going to be first, so I actually now get it, okay? Education is first. Finish all your schooling that you can. If you like it, it's okay to dab into the music, but education is always going to be your insurance that you've got other things that you can do.
What do you want to tell your Arizona fans?
Well, actually, I was talking to Bill Angelini when we first got here earlier today, and I think we're going to be starting to do a lot of the other casinos around here. So it's nice that we started the casino in Soca. This is always going to be our ace place, but we're going to be doing a lot of them. So we should be back very soon.
We are back at the Valentine's Tejano Dance, and look who I ran into.
Luis Martinez, Grupo Misterio. How y'all doing?
How you feeling tonight, Luis? You had everybody dancing.
Feel great. It was a great concert. For those who missed it, Luis Martinez, Grupo Misterio from Tucson, Arizona. Sunny Osuna Sunliners. We had Agustin Ramirez and Grupo Solido. It was a real nice concert. Really, really nice.
So you came out with your first album, Sin Fronteras, and you had hits like Ron con Coca-Cola, Rosa de Oro, La Cadenita. Which you told me the story about La Cadenita. It was actually dedicated to your grandmother.
Yeah, that was dedicated to my grandmother. Her name was Carmen. So, you know, when I was younger, she used to dance around. The Carmen song is recorded back in the 70s. And my grandmother would make tortillas, and she'd be dancing around the table saying, you know, mijito, this is my song.
So I know you are working on a new album right now. Tell us a little bit about it.
Well, I'm working with my producer, Rick Fuentes. Now he's now with the Brown Express. He came back with the Brown Express. So we're coming out with hopefully a better CD than Sin Fronteras. We've got some original tunes coming out there, and we're real excited about this new project because, like I said, we got new music. You're gonna hear probably a couple cover songs, but the rest of them, like six or seven originals, you're going to get.
So what makes Luis Martinez unique and different from every other band?
Well, we stick to the Tejano roots, being the brass section. We have the accordion going on. So, you know, a lot of the groups are going more, I guess you could say, like high-tech, a lot of keyboards and stuff like that. We do implement the keyboards too, but we stay true to the classic Tejano sound.
So I know you have a lot of new projects coming up, and we can't wait to hear them. I am Fanny Girl with Tejano Nation, and this is
Luis Martinez.
Celebrando la gran apertura de las oficinas del Soul Research Management aquí en el sur de Tucson. Y para esto tenemos a la vicepresidente del Soul Research Management, María Gallegos.
Gracias, Leti.
Y al doctor que nos va a acompañar también en esta oficina.
Dr. Carl Diener, director medical.
El doctor director de aquí de esta oficina, ¿verdad? Correcto, mira qué bien habla el español. María, platícanos un poquito de lo que son los estudios que vamos a ofrecer, especialmente en esta oficina, pues va a ser para reclutar a los pacientes con diferentes enfermedades crónicas. Platícame un poquito de los estudios.
Sí, claro que sí, Leti. Mira, ahorita estamos buscando voluntarios que gusten participar. Tenemos muchas indicaciones diferentes, por ejemplo, estudios de anticonceptivos, tenemos asma, trabajamos con diferentes especialistas. El doctor Carl Diener, él es un pulmonólogo, especialista de los pulmones, aparte de médico familiar. Entonces, él es, como él lo mencionó, el director de las dos ubicaciones, director médico, y él es el que supervisa todos los estudios clínicos que tenemos.
Doctor, bienvenido al sur de Tucson. Usted va a estar aquí en esta oficina. You're going to be in this office and helping us, Richard Diaz y myself. Y yo también voy a estar haciendo todo lo que es la mercadotecnia y también directora de lo que es relaciones públicas.
Aparte de los estudios clínicos, estamos implementando un nuevo programa que es de nutrición. Tenemos una nutróloga, al igual que el doctor Carl Diener, donde estamos mirando diferentes formas más específicas al paciente de cómo bajar de peso.
Entonces, todo esto lo vamos a ofrecer aquí en esta oficina de aquí del sur, que es en el 1150 al este de la Pensilvania, que estamos muy cerquitas de la Park y la Ajo. Entonces, estamos casi en el centro del sur de Tucson. Bueno, pues eso lo han escuchado. Esto es lo que vamos a ofrecer aquí en la oficina del sur, del Sol Research Management.
Ahora con Leti. Y en este momento, pues, vamos a hacer el corte de listón para darles la bienvenida a todos ustedes y darles la bienvenida del Sol Research Management aquí en el sur de Tucson. Y pues tenemos
3, 2, 1.
Amigos, ha sido todo por hoy. 30 minutos se nos van volando. Aquí desde los estudios de Arizona Video Production, pues les doy las gracias a ustedes, mis grandes compañeros, mis grandes, ahora sí que son
oficialmente
del equipo.
Y también les vamos a dar las gracias a nuestro nuevo camarógrafo, fotógrafo.
A Gilbert Santillán Jr. de GS Photography. Uh-huh. And let me tell you, he's doing an awesome job. He's doing an awesome job. And he goes around with me. He has a cover events. Uh-huh. And he's doing a great job.
Bueno, pues ha sido todo en esta ocasión, amigos. Acompáñenos todos los domingos a las 10:30 aquí en Azteca América Tucson. Recuerden, amigos, regalar esa sonrisa que nada les cuesta. Continuamos con mucha alegría y mucha diversión todos los domingos en Azteca América Tucson. En
Nuestra Hora con Leti.